Halleluja. 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 Hallelujah song will never cease for our mouth in Jesus' name. Good morning. Welcome to a new day and a new season of love of God. Happy Tuesday, July 12, 2022. This is Love Word, taking you open heaven, a guide to a close fellowship with God. The topic before this morning is whatsoever things are pure. Whatsoever things are pure. Yesterday, we treated whatsoever things are just. On Sunday, we treated whatsoever things are honest. On Saturday, we treated whatsoever things are true. On Saturday also, we treated whatsoever things are true. So today, we are going to look on whatsoever things are pure. Our memory verse shall be found in the book of Psalm 24, verse 4. I read, "He that has clean hand and a pure heart, who hath not lifted up his soul unto vanity, nor sworn deceitfully." Purity can be simply defined as being in one form with nothing else mixed in. In Book of Revelation 3 verse 16, I read, "So then, because thou art lukewarm, and neither cold nor hot, I will spew thee out of my mouth." God is not interested in two-timers. With God, you are either hot or cold. There is no staying in between. Many people think it is okay to live holy and then just commit sin once in a while. God said, "He will spew you out of his mouth if you are lukewarm." He said he is coming back for a church that has no spot at all. According to Ephesians 5 verse 27, which says, "That he might present it to himself a glorious church, not having spots or wrinkles or any such thing, but that it should be holy without blemish." Therefore, if you think that you can accommodate a little impurity in your heart, please think again. My daddy wants you to be spotless clean, completely clean, and completely pure. Those who will be his bride must have no stain on their garment at all. That means every impure thought may be banished out of your mind. Your mind should only be filled with things that are pure, not things that can stain your garment of holiness. It is only those whose hearts are pure that will see God on the last day. Matthew 5 verse 8 says, "Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God." When it comes to spiritual matter, if you are for God, be totally sold out to him. And if you are for devil, be totally sold out to the devil. The Lord says in Isaiah 1 verse 18, "Come now, and let us reason together, says the Lord." Come now, Let us reason together, saith the Lord. Though your sin be as scarlet, they shall be as white as snow. Though they be red like crimson, they shall be as wool. In the spirit, you are either pure white or pure red. There is no sitting on the fence. Whichever one you wish to be is your choice. However, it advises that you live holy and be white. Be pure and be clean. If you want to sit down with the Lord, you have to have a clean mind and a clean heart. And God bless you as you do so. Brethren, our key point for today: only think pure thoughts. Only think pure thoughts. I want us to read the book of Psalm 24, verse 3 to 6, and Philippians 4, verse 8. If you read what I asked you to read yesterday, I will know. So, I want us to read these Bible verses and our Bible in 1 year. Psalm 110, verse 112. Our hymn for today is "Nearer, My God, to Thee," hymn 14. "Nearer, My God, to Thee." Let's pray. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you for giving us the grace to listen to this program and for giving us the opportunity to understand. And I pray as we are going today, you'll be our shepherd in Jesus' name. You'll be our source of knowledge and income in Jesus' name. Amen. This is Love Word. Till I come your way tomorrow, remember to subscribe to the channel and click on the like button. Drop your comment and we'll reply soon as possible. Take care of yourself and have a nice day. God bless you.
Let somebody shout hallelujah.